great and fun and interesting.
Really cool.
Learned a lot from it. And I'd like to think that I've grown as an image maker.
This is a great program.
Fun. I think there's always, I think the thing about photography is that there's always something new to learn. It's not boring. And you'll never know it all. You can just, it's like that lifelong learning career that you'll stay interested.
And when our students leave, I believe the strength of our students is the fact that they're versatile. They can work in many different realms and they can think for themselves. And we've hopefully instilled graphic design principles and, of course, personal vision, composition, and for students to learn how to develop and nurture a personal photographic style.
Three community colleges in the state of North Carolina that offer a degree in photography. And the other two, one of them specializes kind of in the art side, the other one is very equipment oriented and technical oriented. And I think we have a beautiful blend.
You feel like in the first year that you should still start with your basic camera mechanics, black and white film processing, color film processing, real knowledge of the equipment and the materials and processing. You need to know some aesthetics, what makes a good photograph, presentation, and then move in, transitioning that first summer to the digital, where the second year would focus on continuing what you learned in the first year, but putting it in more of an approach of photojournalism, portrait, commercial, so the student, when they leave, would be viable to either continue their education at another college or be ready to go out and be employable in the job market.
We try to give each student some individual care, individual attention. When they come here, they're not just another number, a large class. Our class sizes are relatively small, generally less than 20. And in that frame, in having fewer students, we can offer more individual attention. And when I came on board, I was teaching all traditional type of photographic practices, fundamentals, intermediate, all film-based, all silver-based. And all of a sudden, a few years evolved, and in the early 90s, Kathy came to me and said, "Patrick, there's something going on out in the industry, and it's called digital." And I was so excited about the potential of digital technology, digital photography. I came back and I was like a man with a mission. I found something that I really wanted to pursue and explore. So I convinced the college to give me enough money for 20 computers. And that's when we began our Mac lab. And back in those days, the 20 computers could barely run Photoshop because they didn't have the memory required. But we somehow muddled through and we got new computers and we got newer computers and we wrote more grants and we finally have a state-of-the-art G5 lab now.
I had to go all over the country to try to get the skills that I thought I needed to work in photography, and it seemed to me they were all art-based, very theoretical with not a lot of technique, or they were all technical without much art theory. What I tried to do here was blend the two so the students would have all of what they could use, right, but at an affordable price.
Our program now is a synthesis. It's a melding, it's a complete interface between the traditional darkroom environment and the digital darkroom. We don't even have a distinction between the two. We're teaching photography, and we're teaching photography with tools that the photographers need to go out and make a living in this very dynamic, challenging field. We teach them the traditional as the foundation, learning all of the historical techniques, processes, and we also teach them the digital components, Photoshop, and all the different things that come into working with digital versus analog.
I think we have a student probably in every type of photo business, from art to photojournalism, and probably in just about every state in the union, because they've come from everywhere. We've had students that have won, Debbie Lester won the Dorothea Lange Paul Taylor Prize for her book from the Center of Documentary Studies. We've had students that have been in huge commercial studios, California to Florida, Every type, labs, they're managers, they own their own businesses, they do commercial work, some have worked for in Hawaii, some have worked for Mac. Every major brand. It's amazing that from such a small area that students have been so highly successful.
Come. We offer you not only the technical side, but the art side.
What we need is a desire to get started. We have a huge amount of equipment that we can check out to students. The community college is very affordable. We try to keep the costs down. And then as they go along and they're kind of define what their interest is going to be, then they can add the equipment that they need.
Very proud of our program. I think we've come a long way. Kathy Kroll has been an incredible leader, a visionary, always on the cusp of technology and always getting her crew, Pat, myself, and John, to explore and stay up with the latest in technology. And I do commend her for that. And I believe that our program each year grows. We always have lots of students, and many, many of our students succeed in the field.